It's Game Boy World, and this is Side Pocket. Well, it's another sports game, and once again, it's another game that I'm unsuited to play. At least this time my failing doesn't come from the fact that I don't comprehend or care about the sport. I rather enjoy pool, and Side Pocket is a pretty good adaptation of Data East's classic billiards sim. This isn't even a competitive take on pool, unless you play the two-player mode. It's a score-challenged based on math. Alas, I majored in art and avoided math in college, so I'm absolutely terrible at predicting the motion of the balls in this game. Bad at sports, bad at math. Looks like game over for me. The Side Pocket series, brief as it was, got its start in 1986 in the arcade, and perhaps its coin-op origins can help explain its somewhat unforgiving nature. It's a very straightforward and limited take on pool, but that's not really a bad thing in this case. As 8-bit releases go, Side Pocket offers a nice counterpoint to the likes of Lunar Pool, which took the battle chess approach to the sport and tried to sexy things up for variety. Side Pocket, on the other hand, is about as bare bones an adaptation of the game as you can get. That's especially true on Game Boy. Thanks to the platform's obvious graphical limitations, much of the game involves looking at a tiny sea of numbers. As you line up shots, the balls are replaced by numbers, an optional function in other versions of the game. After all, pool balls are coded by color and pattern, but you can't exactly tell what each ball is supposed to be when you have only four shades of soupy green to work with. The Game Boy version also lacks the little flourishes of other versions of the game, such as the disembodied hand that performs each shot. This doesn't really matter though, because the only thing that actually matters here is your ability to line up shots. And even the Game Boy can handle that just fine. When you enter shooting mode, you aim your shots with a small dotted line that shows the predicted movement of the cue ball for a certain distance, including the angle at which it'll bank from the edge of the table. The line automatically targets the ball with the lowest number, since a key point of both modes is to start with a 1 ball and work your way up to 6 or 9, depending on the mode and difficulty level. The auto-targeting is simply a time-saving convenience, though. You can use the D-pad to alter the angle of your shot as you like, or just pop the low ball directly. Once you select your angle and how much English you want to put on the ball, you can determine the force with which you hit the ball with a moving slider. If this sounds a bit like the setup for Nintendo's Golf, well, yeah, it's basically the same thing. By no means does this boil down to be the same game experience as Golf, though. Data East's programmers did a smashing job of simulating ball physics here, and the cue ball and its targets behave convincingly as they would on a real table. Strike a glancing blow, and your ball will carom away at an angle. Hit a ball straight on with full force, and the kinetic energy will transfer to your target while the cue ball stops dead. Balls roll across the table at differing angles and velocities, bounding and rebounding as they strike one another. I suspect a real pool pro would feel right at home here, though as someone who apparently can't deal with anything resembling geometry, I can't even consistently beat the first round of the tournament challenge mode. Side Pocket's biggest failing is that it offers only two modes of play. It disappointingly lacks the trick shot mode of the 16-bit adaptations and the proper tutorial from the NES port, instead providing a practice mode called 9-ball and a score-based challenge mode called Pocket. 9-ball mode doesn't have any sort of win or lose state. It simply allows players to practice shots, providing feedback when they make an error. You always need to target the lowest numbered ball in this mode, or else you're given an error message. If you shoot without hitting the proper ball, you foul and are allowed to place the ball on the table to take a new shot. It might be more interesting if there were some sort of penalty or goal here besides sinking all the balls, but as a practice mode, it gets the point across. The meat of Side Pocket for Game Boy comes in the Pocket mode, wherein you have to complete several consecutive tables by besting their champions' ever higher scores. Although Pocket mode doesn't include 9-ball mode's requirement that you hit the lowest numbered ball every time, you are scored based on the number of balls you sink on consecutive strikes, as well as how many balls you sink in numeric order. So it's definitely to your advantage to try and clear the table sequentially. In fact, you can't easily pass the first round without doing so, and you can forget about even bothering with later rounds if you can't knock them in one by one. Pocket mode actually starts with a 6-ball setup. You're given a certain number of shots in which to sink 6 balls and hit a score target. If you fail to pocket all the balls, it's game over. But if you sink all 6 without hitting the required score, you're given a second chance to do it with 9, provided you can do so within the shot opportunities left over from the 6-ball round. Your ace in the hole for pocket mode, if you don't mind my mixing game terminologies, is the star icon that appears over random pockets every so often. If you can sing a ball in a pocket highlighted with a star, you'll gain back 2 bonus shot opportunities. The star always seems to appear over the least convenient pocket, so making the most of these opportunities takes some real skill. But since running out of your shot allowance is the biggest danger in pocket mode, it's a skill worth developing. And, well, that's all there is to side pocket. It's super simple, but again, it's hard to fault the game for that. I'm not really sure what else you would want from a portable pool game, besides maybe the trick shot mode. If you can cope with that one omission though, side pocket is a challenging, yet oddly relaxing way to kill some time on Game Boy. While it's a less impressive arcade to Game Boy adaptation than Data East's last project, the shockingly good Lock and Chase, it plays well enough thanks in large part to its HAL caliber ball physics. I just wish I were any good at it. Next time on Game Boy Works, solve a mystery or rewrite history.